said that you have diabetes or high blood pressure, that you don't claim it for yourself? Don't, because of this law. Whatever it is, the mind will become your strengthened and encouraged based on what you give utterance to. I was diagnosed with high blood pressure. That is what you are uttering. That's what you were diagnosed with. Because you are diagnosed, then you know that you need some treatment. Understand? But when you come and you boldly proclaim, I have high blood pressure. Oh, I have it. It's mine. That's what you are uttering, that I have it. And if it is, if I have it, it's mine. You won't take it from me. I know that I'll have to take drug medication for the rest of my life because I have it. It's mine. But if you were diagnosed with it, you're giving utterance to that, and because you're diagnosed, oh, it's not yours. You're giving it back to it belong to, and you will seek help in getting rid of it. No, sometimes doctors will tell you that there are some illness that you never get rid of it. Once you have it, that's it. And that is what you stuck in your mind. I won't get better, so might as well I live with it. Well, my doctor tell me that. That's what he said. He said, well, there's nothing we can do. Go home. That's it. And I'm going on and I say, listen, it's not going to happen. It is not going to happen. I am not giving utterance to that. God promised me that I will have health. He said, he wish above all things that I prosper and that I will be in health. How can man be taking that from me? He promised me that if I come to him, he will take away my sickness and my disease. Here it is. So I go back to him with the words. I said, Lord, you said that. You said I'm to come to you with it. I am here. You said you created me for your glory. And I cannot see how a matched up body like this one that I was in could ever bring you glory. That was what I gave utterance to. That is it. So your words, be careful of the things that you say. Stop telling yourself that you can't. Stop telling, you know, in university, I remember, you know, you hear the thing say, if you don't say you can't, whatever you conceive, you can achieve. I thought it was just words. So I take it as motivational speech. I was in university and we were doing statistics. No, the stats that they were doing was terrible. I just don't like stats. And I keep saying, man, I hate this subject. I don't know where the... No, one stats problem, you work it on two foolscap paper. And if one part of that wrong, if two foolscap paper is wrong, I decide, I rebel against that thing. I don't know why they design anything like that. And I would say I hate that subject. Then at the same time, I was doing psychometry. And in my psych class, the professor outlined to us what happens in the human body when you say you can't do something. So he showed us how the body was designed to protect itself. So if you say you don't like something, what is going to happen? The body is going to send out chemicals to shut down the body when that thing comes near to you. And when I learned that, he said, what you have to do is trick the brain. Whatever you don't like, tell it that you love it. No, from my learning, I decided, I'm kind of experimental. I like to challenge things. So I decided, okay, I know that I hate that. And I know that, and the professor said to us when we're doing that, listen, you do not pass this course in one sitting. There are many in you who have done it 3 and 4 times, so don't expect to pass it on your first sitting. And I'm like, no, that's not going to happen. I have to pay for it. So I'm not going to fail it. So when I heard that, I determined, I said, okay, I am going to trick my brain. So every day you see me, my textbook is a big fat book and two foolscap paper, and I will go. And everybody said, what? I love stats. I think it is the best subject ever made. I love stats. You do? Everybody knows out here that I love stats. So they will come and ask me about it. No, I cannot do it. But because they ask me, I have to go and ask the professor and ask him to help me to work it out because my friends are asking. And he will show me what to do, and I invested in another textbook that was simpler as far as I was concerned. And I started working it out and go back and he will help me. And the thing was coming right. So every day someone said to me, Joan, where should you go? It's statistics, man. I love that. Next thing I know, I had a group. I was teaching a group, and I was teaching them statistics. I still don't know stats. But I give utterance that I love that because I was determined and not failing. Next thing we know, in my group, everybody in my group passes. And they get A's and B's. Only one for this guy, he got a C, and he said, well, that's the biggest A I've ever gotten. Because we did not expect to pass it. As a matter of fact, could you believe that universities start to investigate us? They could not believe because they cannot understand our group of students. Maybe we are still in their black book up there now. I don't know. But they could not understand our group of students, and there was about maybe 6 to 7 of us in that group. And everybody passed. Why? What you give utterance to, your thoughts and your feelings. So I was telling my body I love something. So the feel-good hormones are released. And when it comes, it pumps the adrenaline to do it. Trick the brain. Stop telling yourself these negative things. The Bible says whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, if there be any virtue, if there be, think on those things. Leave the negative thing out of your mind. It will drag you down. Alright? So let's go. Law number 4. Now, this is my favorite law. You might not get it at looking at it for the first time, but it is so deep that this is the one I concentrate on in my life. It says that it is an important law of the mind that when a desired object is so firmly denied as to remove all hope, the mind will soon cease to long for it and will be occupied in other pursuits. But as long as there is any hope of gaining the desired object, an effort will be made to obtain it. That is very, very deep. Be careful of what you wish for. Be careful. Because as long as there's any hope of getting the thing, especially if it's something that's good for you, you will pursue it despite everything else. And I'll tell you two little experience. A young man I know wanted to marry this girl. We tried everything to tell him that it's not a good thing. You cannot do that. It goes against what we believe, you know. And he would hear none of it. He said the Lord pointed out that she was supposed to be his wife. And there's nothing, as a matter of fact, he will have no discussion with us about it. Because why? Already his mind is pursuing that. So therefore, this is where his desire was. And as long as their hope of getting it was there, nothing else makes sense to him. And well, me, rebelliously, me just saying, listen to me. You see when you have problems, because you're going to have problems. You see when you have problems, you don't call me. I don't want you, nothing. Because I told you before, I said, no, the Lord give me so that and that and that. Lo and behold, problem come more than he could ever handle in this. I have never seen anything like that in my life. I have never known trouble like this on one human being head. I never know female can behave this bad. Honestly. I know my poor, but you know you say, but you can't really do it. So now my ears can't eat grass. Because every minute after I hear the hard luck story. And then sometimes, wickedly, we just say, we did tell you. As your God give him to you, so take it. God give you. Take it. Sit in there and take it. You don't have nowhere going. You understand? And I'm telling you, fire is burning and burning bad. So whatever you conceive that you want to do, if it is not according to the will of God, don't stuck it in your mind. Do not stop the thing that goes against the Lord in your mind. As long as there's any hope of you getting it, even if you know it is wrong, you will continue to pursue it. You cannot help yourself. It is a law of the mind. There is something spiritually, listen to this one. It's two incidents and the two of them work out the same way, I tell you. Two of them. One is the female and one is the male. They are both my friends and both of them went through hell. Alright? Because of the same law. I believe based on what I've read in the Bible, that the Lord is calling his children to a life of righteousness. I believe that before the coming of God, that his children will have to be sealed in righteousness and we cannot sin anymore. I believe it. I believe it with all my heart. Because I believe it, it says that once there's any hope of getting that desired object, all effort will be made to obtain it. Because it is stuck in my mind, I'm not saying I'm anywhere near righteous, far, far from it. But I believe with all my heart that the Lord is able to save us and to keep us.